Got another video today. With the success of the Wrinkle Black gauge cluster, decided, what else can I paint Wrinkle Black, right? So, up today is this power steering reservoir. I mean, it don't look terrible, but it can look better. So we're gonna take these screws out, clean them up, because, you know, they need cleaned up if we're gonna do this. This little bracket that I don't use, just gonna hack that off while we're working on it. Take this pulley off, take the line off, take it off the bracket. The only thing with these is, ideally, you take these four bolts out and there's a screw or two inside to pull this reservoir off the pump. This is an old reservoir, by the way. Guys, most of you probably don't even recognize this thing. It's from the mid-90s, early 2000s. Before the turbo inlets came under the manifold and this got in the way, they started putting a reservoir over here. Well, I don't have anywhere to mount the reservoir over here, so I like this style. It's just simpler and it works. So, but you can't find them anymore. Can't get these reservoirs. I can replace the pump, can't replace the reservoir. So I don't want to risk it leaking, so I'm not going to separate the two. I'm just going to mask off the pump while I do this whole thing. I think once I take the pulley off, it shouldn't be a big deal. So, get at it. IG hose. They make it so that the 90 turns right into the intake ramp. I don't know if that's a problem on the other pumps, but on mine it is. So it doesn't just come right off. It's under pressure. Get them cleaned up. Probably a good time to clean that out too, huh? That you see in there, there's those two bolts I talked about. Decided to just take it apart anyway. This little plate in here, there was some gunk around the gasket. I cleaned that off in the parts washer, cleaned that little screen out. I'll give that a good clean in the lid. But I'm gonna take these two bolts out inside here. I'm assuming it's just an O-ring. Never taken one of these apart. Yeah, see, it's just an O-ring right there. That's all that seals it. So I'm trying to replace that O-ring if I can find one, and then get this cleaned up. So at least now I can work on this thing without having to mask off the pump. Alrighty. All cleaned up in the parts washer. You can see there's a little rust there. I want to get this bracket off. There's two tacks here. Can't really tell what else is going on there. I'm trying to find the third tack. We'll figure it out. I'll get this cut off, cleaned up. I'll clean this all down. Hit it with the wire wheel. That's off, hit it with the wire cup. Get this little rust cleaned off. Masked off the pieces. I already coated that one. Get them good and masked. Paint is VHT Wrinkle Plus and black. Already shook it up. So first you start with just a tack coat. So you basically just lightly spray the pieces to get kind of like let them know that they're going to be black now. That does is it helps. It just helps when you don't prep things properly. So I've wiped these all down with acetone, but they had spray paint on them already. I didn't wipe them down too much or it would dissolve the paint. So the tack coat helps in case there's any leftover oils or anything. We'll let that set up and then we'll hit them with a heavy coat. All right, first heavy coat. Alright, 5 minutes. Alright, now that part's over. I got all the paint on. Can't remember if I showed you all three coats or not. But it's on there as heavy as you could get it on several coats without it running. Fortunately, this paint doesn't seem to like to run. So, I mean, you could really cake it on there. What I did after the heavy coats is I removed the masking tape I had around a couple of these areas because the heat gun, I assume, would mess that masking tape up, and I don't want to deal with that later. So I got it off now. It was a little tricky, but you can get it off. So now I'm gonna get the heat gun. It's just, I start heat gunning basically as soon as I get that masking tape off, after I'm done painting. I don't know what the wait period is, but it's probably 5 minutes between last coat and heat gun. it, man. You can't watch, but see how that corner there wants to boil? You can boil it, but don't get it too hot. But, it's pretty wild. I'm gonna flip this one over because it is starting to run from the heat. So hopefully that'll fix that. Reassemble it and show you. And it's reassembled. It, I don't know. I don't like it. I think I got so much paint on it that it's really textured. Probably didn't need as much paint. But, oh, it doesn't look bad. It's a little uneven on the cylinder in a couple spots, but once the pulleys are on, it's in the engine bay. You won't even see it. This is really what you see, the top. And I think it turned out pretty well. The bolts shine back up. So there it is, all back together. This engine's damn near ready to drop in. I just have an oil feed line from here to here, which I can actually put on later, but everything's easier to do out of the car. I can throw a couple more bolts in. I can actually put the gaskets in here yet. I haven't put any of the exhaust gaskets in because I keep taking it apart. I gotta take it apart one more time to hook up these oil cooler lines because they're not gonna have real good access. So I gotta figure that out because I gotta put them on in the car, in the truck, to the cooler to get the lengths to make the AN lines. So I think I gotta take the header off, put the motor in, fit the lines, take the motor back out, put the lines on, then put the header on, and then put it back in. And it's like 10 minutes because there's no cooler lines or anything hooked up. It's just, I won't even put the clutch on the first time I put it in. And that's that. I mean, the eliminator goes in after it's in, it's all sorted. You could put it in now, but it doesn't really matter. And that's it. I'm gonna trim this. This kit came with a 90 off of this turbo, but and then it goes uphill. I don't like it. So I'm waiting on another 45 AN. And then I don't know, this is a torque solution kit. IAG makes the same kit, but it was out of stock. It replaces the port with an AN fitting. So you can run AN hose. But I usually just use the stock one, but the stock one came out here and was hitting the up pipe, so I couldn't use it. So I got that little guy. Now at least it's, you know, easy to change and stuff. But I need the 45 off of that. I don't know why it would come with a 90, but it did. So that's it. And this thing will be ready to frickin' rock and frickin' roll.